Students, welcome to our class on heritage of medicinal plants and their relevance today. Some folk songs and remedies with reference to pomegranate we are going to discuss in this class. Before we actually enter into the class, a quote only to inspire you. Courage is about doing what you are afraid to do. Courage is about doing what you are afraid to do. This is the quote of the day. Let us go straight into our class. Heritage of medicinal plants and their relevance today. What is it? Ayurveda, the Indian science of life, was theorized before a few thousand years and was practiced since then up to this day. Ayurveda is being practiced even today. Ayurveda, allopathy, homeopathy, of course, so many medical treatments are there. Of them, the oldest one is Ayurveda. A bit may come in your midterm or final exam. Ayurveda is called as Indian science of life. It is also called as like that. So, although in theory, the science relates to all forms of life, in actual practice, its efficacy is widely known only in case of human beings. All forms of life, Ayurveda is very much useful. However, in case of human beings, it is much more known. Its efficacy is much more known. That's what. So, what are the basic principles and concepts of Ayurveda? What are the basics? What are the basic concepts of Ayurveda? Plants and trees, along with the rest of the physical world, are involved from five elements: sky, wind, fire, water, and earth. The basic concept is this one. The three humors, Vata, Pitta, and Kapha, are also evolved from these five elements, but are manifest only in the four life forms: humans and animals, serpents and birds, insects and pests, plants and trees. These are the four forms in which these are manifest. They form the basis of Ayurveda. All living organisms are a replica of the vast external universe. This is another thing. There are two forces in the universe, the hot and the cold, which are constantly changing. These are the two forces. The third force, Vayu, which activates these two forces, of course, usually. Despite the fact that all the five elements are present in the constitution of all three human doshas, wind is dominant in Vata, fire in Pitta, and water in the constitution of Kapha. These thrice doshas, we call them, have their characteristic attributes due to the dominant element. Thus, Vata is dry, light, cool, rough, subtle, and motion prone by nature. Pitta is slightly unctuous, sharp, hot, light, full smelling, flowing, and liquid in nature. Kapha is unctuous again, cool, heavy, sluggish, smooth, sticky, and immobile by nature. So, these are the basic characteristics or basic attributes of these things. Vata is dry, Pitta is slightly unctuous, Kapha is unctuous is again. So, the equilibrium of these three in a living organism translates into health, which is the main purpose of Ayurveda. Ayurveda, this is the basic concept. The Ayurveda Shastra has identified certain common elements responsible for the health and diseases. The golden precept that prevention is better than cure. Ayurveda concept is prevention is better than cure. The treatment mainly consists of, Ayurveda treatment mainly consists of administering substances with attributes opposite to the respective vitiated dosha. A dosha is that something, a substance, administering it against the respective vitiated dosha. Diseases occur either by aggravation or attenuation of dosha. Treatment materials are selected in Ayurveda because they act as remedies for the respective diseases. The materials act through, of course, certain things are rasa, taste, guna, quality, virya, potency, pipaka, culmination, prabhava, efficiency. For the purposes of administration, the treatment materials are used in five different forms, that is juice, paste form, decoction form, and cold and hot infusion. Okay, these are the treatment materials. These are used in five different forms. In administering materials to treat the diseases, one of the concepts of Ayurveda is that along with the life, plants also have a definite body structure like human beings. Okay, plants also have definite body structure. So Ayurveda takes that point into consideration. When a patient does not respond to any treatment, he is advised a change in the place and climate. In the same manner, a tree that does not respond to any treatment is transplanted. So the universally accepted principle that love and tender care are the important medical treatment is clearly reflected even in the case of trees in the text of Vriksha Ayurveda. Okay, so these are the basic concepts of Ayurveda. Just to sum it up, of the several medicinal ways, Ayurveda is one of the oldest one. Okay, that's what we tried to understand basically what exactly is it. Now, let us discuss something about a pomegranate, a high value medicinal fruit tree. Pomegranate is a traditional fruit. Historical evidence suggests that man first began planting pomegranate sometime between 4000 to 3000 BC. There is no other fruit crop that has a medicinal value as high as that of the pomegranate. The pomegranate grows in all parts of India. This fruit of myth has been used in many cultures. The uses of pomegranate, possibility is there for a question to be asked either in the midterm or even in the final theory examination. So from that point of view also understand, in addition to acquiring the knowledge about the pomegranate tree. Okay, now pomegranate, otherwise the plant also we call it, that is a hot pepper. Pomegranate is known for its antioxidants, which eliminate harmful free radicals in the body. The antioxidants in pomegranate prevent oxidation and hence increase longevity. In India, the pomegranate has long been recorded as a food medicine of great importance. All parts of the tree, the root, the reddish brown bark, leaves, flowers, rind, above all, the kernels have featured in medicine for thousands of years. Okay, the medical authorities of ancient India described it as a light food and a tonic for the heart. For all the heart problems, the pomegranate is really useful in addition to things which I had already mentioned now. So the ancient medical writers of Arabia considered sweet pomegranate varieties a good laxative, and varieties intermediate between sweet and sour as good for inflammation of stomach and pain for the heart. Digestive disorders, pomegranate juice is of great value in digestive disorders. It is an appetizer, diarrhea and dysentery. The chief value of the pomegranate is its astringent property, which causes cells to expand, not to shrink. Okay, it does allow to shrink. It is a valuable food medicine for the diarrhea and dysentery. So the first use is antioxidant and food uses. Second one is the digestive disorders. Diarrhea and dysentery are the now sore eyes. The crushed pomegranate flowers, when made paste, relieve eye sores. Okay, eye sores. This remedy was particularly, it is being in vogue in India. Intestinal worms, the bark, both of the root and the stems of the pomegranate tree destroy parasitic worms. Okay, in the intestine. Fevers, the juice of the fruit with the addition of a little saffron is useful in fevers to allay thirst. Itching, the skin of the pomegranate fruit is considered highly beneficial in the treatment of itching. Kidney and bladder disasters, The kernels of sour and sweet pomegranate are useful as a medicine. A tablespoon of kernel ground into a fine paste can be given along with a cupful of horsetail soup to dissolve gravel in kidney and bladder, tooth and gum disorders. Powder of the dry and mixed with pepper and common salt is applied for the tooth to prevent its decay. Its regular application strengthens the gums, stops bleeding of the gums. Okay, these are all the most important. A high value medicinal plant as our pomegranate. Now, just let me sum it up. The pomegranate, the uses of pomegranate: antioxidant and food uses, digestive disorders, diarrhea and dysentery, sore eyes, intestinal worms, fever, itching, kidney and bladder. Before that, we tried to understand the heritage of medicinal plants and their relevance today. Okay, the basic principle or concept of Ayurveda. Also, we discussed in this class. Before we complete the class, one more small thing about the pomegranate, the last part of our class. Some folk remedies from villages in southern Gujarat on pomegranate are: boil 100 grams of pomegranate rind in 4 cups of water. Use this infusion to brush teeth every morning to treat gum inflammation and infection. This is what, 100 grams of pomegranate rind and 4 cups of water. Okay, that's one. Boil the rind of the fruit and rinse mouth with this infusion 2 to 3 times a day to disinfect tonsils and throat and treat canker sore. Okay, this is also one of the advantages. Soak 50 grams of dried pomegranate root bark overnight in 1 to 2 glasses of cold water. Boil it for a few minutes. The following morning, let it cool and drink 2 or 3 times at a 15 minutes interval to expel, of course, tania, the tapeworm. So the tapeworm can be controlled like this. These are the folk remedies with reference to pomegranate. So let us sum it up once again. In this class, we try to understand heritage of medicinal plant, basic principles and concepts of Ayurveda, something about the pomegranate. Again, before formally say thank you, the quote of our today's class is, courage is not about doing what you are afraid to do. Okay, all the best. Study well. May God bless you. Write all your exams very well. Thank you very much. May God bless you.